and said it was time to ring the register on GameStop when the stock was at $400. See, I thought that was common sense, but the meme stock guys saw it as a declaration of war against them. I just ripped out my catheter so I could have a little more focus. Remember, at the time, GameStop was up more than 1,700%. Remarkable run. So I figured people should take something off the table. I didn't even think it was anything. I mean, not a lot. Put it this way. Not long before I went into surgery, it was for a burst cyst in my spinal column, I'd admonish the short sellers in GameStop for being pigs. They'd watch the video game retailer stock down to near oblivion, but they kept betting against it, assuming it'd be like shooting fish in a barrel. The shorts didn't take their gains while they had them, and they were obviously being pigs. And in January, those little piggies got slaughtered. Now, suddenly, I was saying the same thing about the bulls, who'd watch their favorite stock go from the single digits to 400. Truthfully, it was one of the best calls I ever made. GameStop swiftly fell to $40 less than a month later. But the GameStop's fan base from Wall Street Bets, it doesn't matter that I was correct. It's meaningless. To them, anyone who recommends selling is the enemy, which is why I've become a hated figure on Reddit's Wall Street Bets, probably the most hated person in their universe. And that's the betting sheet that's ground zero for meme stock investing. According to these younger investors, or at least I assume they're younger, given that it's all anonymous, selling GameStop is just an outright sin, no matter how much money has been made. They hate those on the other side of the trade, particularly short sellers, but also baby boomer guys like me who cancel people that take some profits because of my core tenants. In other words, my learned behavior is worthless to these people who castigate anyone who tries to help them, even when those people turn out to be right. You could have saved yourself a fortune if you sold GameStop at 400 and bought it back at 40. Now, I understand risk. It's possible to be too prudent, but I'm not against GameStop or AMC at these levels. GameStop's currently below where I told you to ring the register in January. It's now getting hammered in the after-hours trading. Wake up a terrific quarter, frankly. Management did so. They said they'd sell maybe another 5 billion shares in what's known as an at-the-money transaction. You probably won't even notice it, frankly, if you're in the stock. These companies now have the ability to reinvent themselves because higher stock prices have allowed them to raise capital. I like that. That said, if you've ridden them up from much lower levels, hey, take a little off the table. These stories could always get dinged like GameStop's currently doing, even though the numbers were good. And they're bringing in a couple of really seasoned Amazon alums to run the company. I've been talking about great people.